Hi, my name is Vaman Deshmukh, and in this session, we are going to study the second part of control structure, that is iteration or iterative statements. In the previous session, we learnt the first part of control structure, that is selection statements. As you know, the control structure in PL SQL controls the flow of the execution of your program. It has two types, that is selection statements and iteration statements, and this session is about iterative statements. So here in PL SQL, you typically have three types of loops which go for iteration. Iterative statements typically means the repeat set of instructions, you know, the given number of times to achieve the desired result. Here you have basic loop, you have a while loop, you also have a for loop, and there is a variation as well in for loop. Using these three loops, you can go for iterative functionality in your program. Let us begin with the basic loop. Basic loop, as you can see on the syntax on the screen, begins with the keyword loop, and as we have seen previously as well, ends with the keyword end loop. So whatever you write between loop and end loop will be repeated a certain number of times depending on, you know, the boolean expression condition that you give in the exit statement. Let us try this on the screen. As you can see on the screen here, the program is, you know, I have declared a variable I, and its initial value is 1. And in the begin block, I have given the loop structure. So it begins with the keyword loop followed by the dbms underscore output dot put underscore line, that is DOP statement, which is meant to print the text on the screen. Following to which, I have given here one increment condition. This increment condition is necessary so that the value of the given variable keeps increasing, and after some iterations, the exit condition becomes true. This exit condition can be written in two ways. I will show you both the ways. And this is followed by end loop. And finally, the end block. I run this program, and as you can see the output on the screen, it's 1 to 10. As I told you, the same if, you know, the exit condition, as of now it has been written like if boolean expression then exit end if. It can also be written like, you know, exit when, and directly, you know, the boolean expression. All this stuff is not required for that. This is a shorter way introduced since Oracle 11g, started since Oracle 11i. So here exit when I greater than 10, when this condition becomes true, the loop exits, and you can see the output on the screen. The output is 1 to 10 numbers. So initial value of I is 1, it prints the value 1, and in the next line I colon equals I plus 1, I's value becomes 2, which is followed by the exit condition that if I is greater than 10, the loop should terminate. But as of now, the I's value is only 2, and the condition is not yet true. So the loop continues again. This loop will continue 10 times. It will iterate 10 times. And after that, here, with this increment statement, the I's value becomes 11, and the condition becomes true, then the loop exits. So basic loop typically works like this. Basic loop has one exit condition. On the other hand, while loop is there, which has one entry condition. While loop, its syntax, as you can see on the screen, while boolean expression loop statements and increment statement as well. So here, while loop checks an entry condition in the beginning itself. If the condition is true, then the iteration of the loop starts. So there may be a possibility that if condition is false in the beginning itself, then the loop may not iterate at all, as opposite to basic loop, where the loop will iterate at least once, and if the condition is true, then the iteration will continue, and if the condition is false, then the iteration of the loop will stop. Here, using while loop, if the condition is true, only then the controller will enter the loop, otherwise loop will not execute at all. Let us try this. Here I will slightly modify this code. I will put here while and some entry condition, and followed by the keyword loop. While I is less than equals 10, if this condition is true, then the controller will enter the loop. Here, because I got the entry condition in the beginning itself, I will not need exit condition, but I will definitely need this increment statement. I am saving this and I am going to execute this, and as you can see on the screen, the output is again the same one, that is 1 to 10. You can compare these two examples. Here, using basic loop, it begins with the keyword loop, and within the loop it has one exit condition. On the other hand, using while loop, it begins with the keyword while, there itself it has one entry condition, and within the body of the loop it has the executable statements and only one increment statement. The basic difference between basic loop and while loop is basic loop has an exit condition, whereas while loop has an entry condition. Apart from that, you have the third loop, that is for loop. Syntax is pretty simple: for variable in range loop, followed by statements, and end loop in the end. Here, using for loop, you will get implicit variable declaration, implicit increment of the variable by 1, and at the same time implicit exit as well. So as in the case of basic loop and while loop, here in for loop you do not have to do all these things. For loop will take care of that by itself. So let us try this on the screen. So here I am writing the program. Because this is for loop, I do not need to declare any variable as such. So I am directly starting from begin block. I am not using declare block at all. And as you can see here, I am directly there in the begin block. As you can see on the screen here, I am there in the the loop for I in 1.10 loop, as you saw in the syntax as well. For variable in range loop is the syntax, and here as well, for variable in the given range and loop. So here the for loop structure, it implicitly declares a variable, it implicitly increases the value of the variable by 1, and once it reaches the end of the range, it automatically exits. As you can see the output on the screen, it again prints numbers 1 to 10. Using this for loop, instead of this 1.10, you can give any small number to any bigger number. For example, if you want to print the numbers, let us say 11 to 20, you can very easily do that. The output is 11 to 20. Similarly, you can also give minus numbers to plus numbers. For example, minus 10 up to plus 10, very much possible. You could see the output, minus 10 is up to 110, up to plus 10. Not just that, any practically any smaller number to any bigger number you can give as a range, and the same range will be repeated. As you learn more concepts, instead of this numerical range, you can give other ranges as well. Here, like, you can give a cursor here, you can give an inline cursor as well here. So this loop is very much used in PL/SQL. Assume you want to print the reverse order. For example, 10 to 1 if you want to print. In that case, if you give a reverse range here itself, then it will not work, because whatever is the order you want to print it, the range should always be defined from a smaller number to a bigger number. But there is another way you want to achieve the same result. Here you must use the keyword reverse. So for variable in reverse range loop, using the keyword reverse and by giving the ascending range, you can get the desired output, that is 10 to 1. So your for loop that gives you ascending order as an output, and you have a reverse for loop that gives you descending order as an output. And this loop has so many advantages. It has implicit variable declaration, it has implicit variable incrementation with 1, and it also has implicit exit condition. So these are the three ways you can have iterative statements in PL SQL. They are basic loop, while loop, for loop, and in addition to that, reverse for loop. That's a little about iterative statements. Thanks for watching video. To watch more such videos, please visit Naresh Technologies on youtube.com. Thank you.